Surveys and quizzes are another great tool to engage and understand your subscribers' interaction with your product or service. Using these tools allow your audience to voice their opinion and share their ideas. This could build better relationships and trust with your customers, which will lead to a highly loyal clientele. On your MailerLite dashboard, head to Sites, create a new landing page, or edit an existing one. For this tutorial, I'm going to edit one that I previously created, but you can watch our tutorial on how to create a landing page linked in the description below. All right, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom of this page. Click the plus sign under this block and let's select survey. To edit this block, click on the edit icon. In the sidebar, there are three tabs: questions, rules, and settings. The questions tab is where you'll be adding your survey questions. And there are 9 types of questions that you can add to this survey. We've got the intro, and this step is compulsory and introduces the survey. I suggest adding a short description here. Satisfaction score. This question asks participants to provide a satisfaction score of 1 to 5 using smiley faces, stars, or heart icons. Net promoter score. This question asks participants to provide a satisfaction score from 1 to 10. Multiple choice. A question with multiple answers. Multiple image choice. A question with multiple images as answers. Open question, questions with an open text box. We also have the like and dislike, a question that can be answered with a positive or a negative response. For example, thumbs up or thumbs down, smiley face or sad face, etc. Sign up form. This step displays the sign up form to collect the email addresses of participants. Outro. This is highly important as it indicates to your survey participants that the survey is over. Each survey is limited to 30 questions. Click Add Question and then click the Edit icon to modify the question, description, and answer. Now, adding rules to the survey is essential to make the survey functional. In the Rules tab, you can predefine a rule that skips questions based on how a participant responded to the previous question. For example, you can create a rule that if a participant selects a certain answer, they skip to a particular question. To add rules to your survey block, click Add a New Rule. Set your conditions. And click Save. Under the Settings tab, you can apply design settings to your survey block. It works just like any other settings tab we went over in previous videos. Normally I would save this, but I want to show you the quiz block. And as I mentioned before, you can't have both on one page. So let's delete this block and add a quiz. Now, going through the same process, click the plus sign and add a quiz block or drag it from the sidebar. Now let's edit the quiz block settings. Fundamentally, quiz and survey blocks are very similar in their look and in their setting. In the sidebar, we see the same options: questions, rules, and settings. The questions tab is where you'll add your quiz questions. Now, there are 5 types of questions you can add to a quiz, and they're very similar to the survey. There's an intro, multiple choice, multiple image choice, a sign-up form, and there's a quiz result. Now, this compulsory step shows participants the quiz results. Here, visitors will see their quiz score with options to share the results or to take the quiz again. Now, just like the survey, each quiz is limited to 30 questions, and to add questions to your quiz, click the Add a Question Template button. So far, almost identical to a survey. To modify the questions, descriptions, and answers, click on the Edit icon. So now I'll add a few more questions and rules to my quiz. Very important to remember, when using multiple choice questions, be sure to check the box next to the correct answer. And don't forget to save everything you create. Once your landing page is active, you'll be able to see the results of the quiz or survey in the Overview tab. Go to Dashboard, Sites, choose the page and click Overview, then click on the Survey Report.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to click the bell button below so you don't miss any new tutorials. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our newsletter. The link is in the description section below. Have an awesome day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.